Here we are. Top of the, or bottom of the ninth. Game's on the line.
To the dome.
Going to the dome to watch Seattle versus the Toronto Blue Jays at home. We wanted to be there to see Thames' first action in a Seattle Mariners uniform. Thames is a big fan. We're a big fan of his. I guess he's a big fan of ours too. So he's always interacting with the podcast. We made sure we got down there to see his big re-debut at the Sky Dome, and it was just set up to be a great day.
And next thing you know, we're on the 401. And about 45 minutes, hour later, we're in Toronto. We're heading down the Lakeshore Boulevard there, talking about our favorite trips to the Dome.
Recently, last year, one of the last games of the season, I was sitting up at the 500s, and there was this guy that was passed out about 10 rows down from us, and he was passed out for innings, and the game was going to extra innings, and people were starting to razz him big time. So there was a chant that's kept growing and growing and growing, and everybody in the 500s was chanting, "You are sleeping."
Nice. Did he wake up?
He took so long to get up to the point where I was like, Amanda, that man might be dead. Like, for real. Like, it was about 20 minutes past when there were several people that had been poking him.
And poking
waking
him.
Up. And then paramedic and police officer and security come up to check him out. And he still wasn't working. The cop was kind of sitting back. And then I was like, yo, he might be dead. Like, legit. After we were having so much fun.
No longer funny.
But I'll never forget the guy who stood up for this man. Was one guy after everyone was chanting, "You are sleeping," and it kept going. And this just voice from above, seemingly protecting this man, goes, "Hey, leave the man alone. He's trying to sleep. Haven't you ever seen a man sleep before? Let him sleep. He's tired." And I was like, slow clap.
Slow clap. Right voice of reason.
Me. I was like, yeah, man, he's just catching some Z's, whatever. So I'm the 500s. That made my day. Anyways, the guy did wake up eventually. And he
so
was just
he
like,
drunk or he was just soft?
I think he was just passed out, honestly. Just not drunk. And everyone was clapping for him and applauding. And,
nice.
That was the time I almost thought I saw a dead man at the door.
First time Brad and his dad and his sister took me down, we met, we got to meet Joe Carter and everyone, but they're playing the Mariners.
Yep.
And that just happened to be the time I finally convinced my mom to let me shave my head bald. Because they were playing Mariners at Jay Buhner.
Oh, yeah.
Right? I was a bit of a Mariners fan growing up also.
Mom wasn't down for the cause, eh?
Well, she wasn't, but I always grew up playing basketball, right? And as soon as I chopped the mullet off as a real youngin, I realized I didn't want any hair. So I was trying to shave it off young, and I was only 13. I don't know if I already said that. So
did you want to go completely bald or like down to number one on the race?
Well, I always wanted to go right bald, and Jay Buhner was bald, right? So yeah. I had to do it all the way. And because I used to, like, I would leave the top and shave the side bald and that, right? So I had shaved most of my head, so I had to go all the way.
Right.
And finally, leading up to the Mariners game, I dropped it in my mom's ear and convinced her. And now it's pretty much history. We sat three rows behind the Mariners dugout. Yeah. Never forget that. Buhner and Griffey went a combined 0-for-7 with 6 strikeouts.
Hey, there you go.
That's legit.
Good.
Yeah, well, it was good. I was a huge Griffey fan growing up. I mean, I don't know who wasn't really. I've never heard anyone that didn't like him.
That's my favorite player of all time right there.
Yeah, I mean, I had Blue Jay posters too, but there's definitely a Griffey poster on my wall growing up.
Yeah, man.
Definitely lucky as a kid growing up.
Yeah.
Thanks, Brad.
So we arrived at the dome, we parked, headed up to the main level there, and what do you know, Nick needed more food, so his double burger wasn't enough, got himself some street meat out front.
So I grabbed my hot dog, I'm a just ketchup kind of guy, definitely don't want to let Skip know about that, and I loaded up my dog there with ketchup and started mowing down, filling up before the dome, didn't want to spend too much money inside.
And we were looking outside, and there's always the guys that are selling the the pictures and everything. And I saw one that I had my eye on. It was a picture of One Direction, beautifully drawn. And I was thinking about purchasing that for $10.50, but the guy that was selling them took offense to that. And he was mad because he saw me goofing around. And Brad had the camera trying to get a nice shot of that, and he ripped it right out of my hands. And of course, as soon as he did that, our friend from Jay's Care was walking up to say hi to us, and she saw the shenanigans going on there at BIB we were creating. But hey, what can you do? The guy was mad. I was thinking about buying that picture. So next on the list, of course, was to hit up the Jay shop, see what they got on sale, because I'm a bargain shopper, folks. And of course, naturally, BIB gravitated straight towards the kids section, and Nick was trying on some new batting gloves, checking out his swing.
It's all in the wrist. It's all in the wrist. It's all in the wrist.
Clearly we're on a mission here today. Back in blue had to go say what's up to E. Thames. We finally got inside the dome. Next thing you know, we're rushing down the first base side there, down the stairs, trying to get front row. Of course it wasn't too hard because the place is empty. But we're up on the wall there, hanging out, looking for some foul balls, and Thames doing his thing there in right field. And out of nowhere, he gives us a little forearm fist pump there to the sky, so he saw us. It was pretty cool. And we're just hanging out, having a good time there, waiting for the game to start.
I saw you play, and his coach called
me. I messed up. Next thing you know, E. Thames looks over, and he signals like this, and he's wanting a bib shirt. And all of a sudden, I realize the whole way down, I'm telling the guys, I'm like, I feel like I forgot something, you know, something's missing. I realize right at that very moment, I was about to be sick to my stomach, I forgot the shirt.
I'm not gonna lie.
I'm gonna wear it behind me.
I can still send you one.
Do it. How's the podcast?
Oh, good, man.
Hey, folks, skip
thank you, Eric.
Yeah, man.
Appreciate it, brother.
We're having fun with that.
Yeah. Remember when we had
two or so?
We got some tickets up top, so we're gonna try to come down there for it.
Yeah, dude.
Okay.
Headed up to our seats, we went and checked out Jamie Campbell and Jose Cruz doing the pregame show. Zahn is on a little vacation, believe he was gone fishing from what I heard from the last broadcast. So we saw Jose Cruz and Campbell and checked them out. Always fun to watch them do their thing, very professional, always hold down the fort. After that, headed up to our seats in the 500 levels. My ears were popping, I think might have had a little blood coming out of them, but those seats were care of. Skip 101 decided to give us some seats because he appreciated the marketing that we're giving him, getting his classes out there, 555 Skip 101. So he bought us some tickets up there. We had to watch the game binoculars, but needless to say, it's enjoyable to watch the game just about anywhere at the Sky Dome, and we had a blast.
We got two on
the shortstop. Number 5, Udell.
Currently heading bottom second. We got a 2-1 thriller on our hands. KJ at the dish.
Oh.
Lynn gets gunned out at third. Never make your third out at third base.
So once the fifth or sixth inning rolled around, we thought it'd be a good time to head down to the Blackberry booth and see if we can get a chat in with Jamie Campbell, our homeboy, our amigo. He's a supporter of the podcast. He's a fan of Skip. Gotta appreciate that. So is Zahn. These guys are helping us out, telling us encouraging things, and keep up the great work. Big fans of Skip, big fans of the podcast. You gotta love that. We had a great opportunity to chat with him. He gave us the time of day. We talked for about 15, 20 minutes, I have to say. All baseball talk, had some fun, joked around. It was great. Jamie Campbell, really appreciate the time.
Here we are, bottom of the ninth. Game's on the line. We've got KJ, Aaron Sebia, and Rajay coming to the dish.
So the ninth inning came very quickly. The Jays were still down by a run. So what did the BIB boys do? Bust out the rally caps. Me and Nick were rocking those, hoping for a little bit of luck. Unfortunately, the Jays didn't get it. Although there was a close play at the bag where Rajay was called safe, I think he was out. There was an even closer play right after that where Ghost was called out. And I think he was out, but it was a lot closer than one before. Either way, long story short, the Jays fell to the Seattle Mariners by one stinking run.
That was closer than Rajay's play.
Tough one, boys. Looks like we took the L. Well, we got to talk to E. Thames. That's a good day.
Talk to Sportsnet Jamie Campbell.
That's right, Sportsnet Jamie. Good to talk to you again. And saw another Blue Jays L. I think that's 3 for 3 this year when we've come together. Have we seen them win yet?
No, we haven't.
I don't think we're going to come again to another game the rest of the season. As a group of three, clearly doesn't Mariners, help out. But I'll be back for another Jays game, hopefully pick up the W. Hope you all enjoyed BIB 37. It's time to go home. And we're out.
His record now 8-6.
Back in blue, baby!
Wilhelmson, his 25th season. For all the post-game stories, stats, and information, go to BlueJays.com.